today we are going to study about the process of blood coagulation. If we take the blood coagulation is initiated by the platelets, are also called as what? Thrombocytes. Blood clotting, conversion of liquid blood into semi-solid jelly-like structure is called as blood coagulation. What is blood coagulation? Conversion of liquid blood into semi-solid jelly-like substance is called as blood coagulation. What happen whenever the body cells or the blood came in the contact of external factor? At that time, the process of a blood coagulation is get initiated. Then why the blood get interact with the external or internal factor? Any kind of the intrinsic process or extrinsic process which leads to the damage of internal tissue or damage of body surface, which result in oozes of blood from the blood vessel. As the blood started to oozes out from the blood vessel due to the intrinsic as well as extrinsic process, it leads to the conversion of liquid blood into semi-solid jelly-like structure. And the process of conversion of liquid blood into semi-solid jelly-like substance is takes place in stepwise manner, also called as cascade mechanism. Cascade mechanism means any of the event, any of the process which takes place in stepwise manner. Now, what are the different steps involved in the process of blood coagulation? There are about 12 different blood clotting factors helps in the mechanism of blood coagulation. Out of these 12 factors, 6th factor is not in active use during the time of blood coagulation. Interaction of these factors in stepwise manner, in one after another manner, in a cascade manner, leads to the formation of the enzyme called as thrombin. Mainly this thrombin is helpful for the process of blood coagulation. But how this thrombin is formed? Thrombin is formed by the action of thromboplastin. Thromboplastin helps in the formation of enzyme prothrombinase. This enzyme prothrombinase, which helps to inactivate the heparin and also helpful to convert the inactive prothrombin into the active thrombin. The enzyme thrombin, which helps to convert soluble blood protein called as a fibrinogen. That means inside the blood, fibrinogen is present previously. This fibrinogen is present in the soluble form, so only gets circulated throughout the body with the blood. But whenever this fibrinogen is get converted into insoluble fibrin, it start to form an meshwork. This meshwork is helpful to enmesh the blood cells like RBCs, WBCs and platelets to form a clot. And this clot now can be referred as a semi-solid structure called as blood coagulation. To complete the process of blood coagulation, it requires about 2 to 8 minutes. Within a 2 to 8 minutes, as per the severity of wound, the process of blood coagulation is get completed. Now, this blood coagulation can be summarized with the help of a chart. This chart gave us an idea how actually the process of blood coagulation is get completed. Now see here, whenever there is an cut on the body surface, blood start to oozes out. This blood, which contains an blood platelets, these blood platelets start to produce prothromboplastin. In the presence of Ca++ calcium, this prothromboplastin is get converted into thromboplastin. Now, this thromboplastin is helpful to convert prothrombin into thrombin. Here, you can observe the thromboplastin plus Ca++ are helpful to form thrombin. Thrombin it is active and prothrombin it is inactive. This active thrombin helpful to act upon insoluble fibrinogen, and this insoluble fibrinogen is get converted, soluble fibrinogen is get converted into insoluble fibrin. This insoluble fibrin, it start to form a fibrin polymers. That means it forms an meshwork. Now, in this meshwork, RBCs, WBCs and platelets are start to entangled, which result in first upon decreasing in the flow of blood through the cut. And finally, this blood flow is get reduced and get stop because there is a formation of a plug at the region of a cut. It's all for the process of blood coagulation. Thank you.